In July last year, Bugiri Municipality Legislator Asman Basalira was granted leave of parliament to introduce a private member's bill on counterfeits. Since then, Basalira embarked on countrywide stakeholder consultation, and these were concluded in Kampala.
First of all, for the first time, we are bringing a piece of legislation that comprehensively defines counterfeit goods and services. Comprehensively. So we are looking at counterfeit at the level of production, manufacturing, labeling, packaging, repackaging, importation, exportation, in very broad terms. Okay? Because the existing pieces of legislation don't go to that level. They are not very broad. That's one. Number two, we are looking at both counterfeit and substandard. Okay? And it's a very important concept, a very important concept that we are introducing this legislation. Because every counterfeit is substandard, but not every substandard is counterfeit. It's very important. I can have a registered product, and it's not counterfeit.
Key among the introductions of the bill that seeks to prohibit trade in counterfeit goods that infringe upon protected intellectual property rights is the introduction of multi-sectoral approach among government agencies in the fight against counterfeits.
We are bringing a multi-sectoral approach. The citizenry, the private sector, and the public sector are now coming together to address this aspect. So the element of private participation in implementation is also being brought on board, but also the multi-sectoral coordination. We want these agencies, for example, UNBS.
The bill also seeks to introduce heavy fines and penalties to counterfeiters as well as aiders. According to a report by the World Customs Organization, illicit trade accounts for approximately 3.3% of global trade, leading to a significant economic loss for governments and legitimate businesses. In Uganda, this loss is estimated at 6 trillion shillings annually.
So businesses like ours have to deal with, among other things, unfair competition from substandard and counterfeit alternatives. So we are very proud that a law has come up to address this. Counterfeits not only have a detrimental impact on the reputation of affected establishments like ours, they also cause a health hazard to consumers.
Basalira says he will require a certificate for financial implications from the Finance Ministry before tabling the bill on the floor of Parliament for fast reading. He is hopeful that the bill will be processed, passed and assented to by the president before the end of this year. Sigeda Airlines plans to spend $95 million on procurement during 2024-2025 financial year and is exploring ways of supporting local suppliers to earn a bigger slice of that spend. The money will be split among suppliers, services and works. The national carrier also expects to hit the 700,000 passenger milestone at the end of 2024 on the back of capacity and frequency growth on key routes. The numbers were announced by the chief executive officer recently in Kampala. According to Jennifer Bamtarachi, the local supplier database has grown to 200 and 120 billion shillings has been paid out to local supplier contractors and over the 5 years that the airline has been in operation. According to provisional numbers, Uganda Airlines expects to report 480,000 passengers carried during financial year 2023-2024. The full year numbers of 2024, however, is expected to be about 700,000 passengers. The aircraft has enabled the carrier to tap into growing demand in routes such as Nairobi, Kinshasa and Johannesburg, while also creating room for more frequencies.